as I was researching this video to show you how to create a color system in Figma, I moved in the process of doing this from doing it in 2 hours to doing it in 2 minutes. And that's what I want to share with you today. The quickest way to generate your color palette in Figma due to the power of Figma plugins. So let's get started. Rather than getting started on a website somewhere, selecting your colors, your color palette, whatever type of color harmony you want to use, and then going through the steps of creating different shades, also using a website or maybe another plugin to generate those shades, then creating the variables from each different shade color, which will probably be the way you will find this done in every other video, because that's how I've done it in the past as well. Today, we're going through the shortcut of using one plugin to do all these steps at the same time. Let's get to it. If you're starting from scratch and you don't have an existing brand, the first question you have to ask yourself is, who is your target audience? The product that you're creating, whether it's a mobile app or a website, who are you creating it for? What emotions do you want to create for your user? Do you want them to feel fun? Is it a serious product? Do you want to come across as professional and very serious? Is it a government product? These are the questions that you want to ask so you can define your brand. And that's when you want to leverage color theory to define your color palette. Colors are not a random choice. There are endless articles on the web that talks to you about the principle of UI design and how to use colors, because there's a whole psychology to colors. Each color conveys a certain meaning. So once you've defined the main colors you kind of want to go for, I found a series of fantastic plugins that will make our job easier. One of them is this color scale generator that allows you to choose a color. So let's say you started here in Canva and you actually like this color. You copied it. You can come here, paste it in this plugin and click create. You can choose how many shades or tints that you want, and it will simply generate them for you. And if you were to go this route, the next step that you would have to do is to actually go here. We have to do an additional step here, which is renaming your layers. So I will click Command R and I can call this purple and then current name, because as you can see, the current name that the plugin generated has a slash in it. So this will rename my layers to purple dash the actual shade that it generated. With all these selected, I will use another plugin called Color Variables Creator. Once again, I searched for so many of them and this one seemed quite efficient. It lets you name your color collection and the mode, choose the mode that you're putting them in. And when I hit create, now my variables are created. Let's validate this happened. If I click on local variables, you can see it generated all these variables for me, which would be fantastic if we wanted to create many colors. So this is one way of doing this, but guess what? There's even a much faster way that combines step one and two together, and it's mind-blowing. I'm gonna go to plugins and widget, and I wanna show you this plugin I just discovered today. It's called Color Wheel Palette Generator, and this combines the two steps we just described. So rather than going on a website somewhere to choose your color palette, let's say the palette you want to go with is blue. Somewhere you want shades of blue and you want a monochromatic color, something that retains similar colors. You don't want it to be very complex. You can choose everything that you want here. You can even specify the exact hex color that you want to build your palette on. But everything we just saw is combined in this plugin. And all you have to do is click Generate Palette. And guess what? The plugin creates this beautiful palette for you, including all the neutral shades that you will need for your text. But not just that. Look what happened in my local variables. When I open local variables, there's a new palette called Color Wheel Player, and it already created all these palettes for me. I don't have to go and create the variables myself. The plugin did everything from choosing the palette to generating the styles right here to actually creating the variables for me. Wow. Thank you, plugin creators in Figma. This is 2 hours job done in 2 minutes. If you found this video helpful, please like, comment, and subscribe to my channel. Thank you so much.